testing a pressure switch in just a normal residential unit is what we did. We're going to zero our unit. Okay, our unit zero. We have this T that we got from just a normal hardware store. You can see it has different size. We have different size tubing on there depending on your airflow switch. We just found that's the easiest thing to do. Then we cut a portion of our high temperature tube off the end so that we can take, and we're going to pull the tube off of our pressure switch, the part where it connects to our inducer draft motor. We're going to slide the tube that we put on our T onto that same port, and we want to go straight through. This is the tube that goes back up to our pressure switch. We want to go straight through and then connect our meter to the T portion of that. We want to T it in. Then we're going to turn our furnace on, and it's already calling for heat. We can see our pressure change. And this furnace isn't supposed to turn on until we have positive 0.138 and we're plenty high. Basically, that just told us that our pressure switch is good. Now, when we're done with that, all we have to do is shut off our furnace, pull our T off, pull our tube that was going up to our pressure switch off, put it back on our inducer draft motor, and we are all done with our pressure test.